It's mostly science and fiction. Mostly.
Black Sails, the prequel to the classic novel by Robert Louis Stevenson, Treasure Island. It is one of the finest, if not the finest, pirate thing I have ever seen. I highly recommend you watch this series. I was originally going to do a whole history versus fiction video regarding Black Sails, but decided to do a finale breakdown instead because the history video would be super massive and frankly, I just can't be fucked. So let's get the big one out of the way. What happened to Captain Flint? In the finale, we get Long John Silver retelling how he sent Flint away to basically the slave farm, where he meets up with his thought-to-be-dead lover, Thomas Hamilton. They reunite, and tears and jizz are sprayed all around. Happy ending. In a way, I mean, they're still both work slaves, but they're not only alive, but also reunited. Oh. However, there are signs that suggest that perhaps this story told about the fate of Flint is all an elaborate fabrication by Long John Silver. The last we see of Flint outside of a retelling or a flashback is him at gunpoint with Silver. They exchange final words and then it cuts to Silver's men being startled by birds flying away. This could indicate that there was a gunshot, as in, Silver killed Flint and simply bullshitted the story to get back in Maddie's pants. One of John Silver's most valuable skills is his ability to weave an elaborate tale. Throughout the entire series, he has basically talked his way out of everything. Perhaps this is just another one of his lies, but perhaps not. Another hint that Flint's fate is not so obvious is Rackham's speech about writing one's own story. History makes itself, blah blah blah. In the book Treasure Island, Flint was said to have drunk himself to death, so not quite a happy ending in reality. And by reality, I mean a total work of fiction, as Flint is an entirely fictional character. Some of the other characters who did exist in the real world also get grim future endings, but more on that in a bit. Overall, as history fades into legend and legend into myth, and who really knows what happened to Flint? Also, like I said, he's not a real person, so, you know, fucking, a story is true, a story is untrue. As time extends, it matters less and less. The stories we want to believe, those are the ones that survive. Despite upheaval and transition and progress, those are the stories that shape history. Anyway, I like to think that the writers intentionally set it up so that the viewers choose the ending that suits them best. Few shows leave things ambiguous these days, and I think Black Sails handled this well. For the soft cocks like myself, we get a happy gay ending. For hardened robots, you get Flint's grim execution on the island. Aww. However, if he was executed, how do we end up with the map to Flint's treasure in the book Treasure Island, as he was the only one that knew its location? Maybe Billy, who ends up marooned on the island, spends years discovering it, draws the map, then heads off to the mainland where the Treasure Island begins. What do you think happened to Flint? Did he die, or did he live on and have lots of anal sex with Tom Dog the Power Bottom? Anyway, while we're on the island, let's talk Billy! Billy! We have always known that Billy is Billy Bones from the book, but the way the series ended, it doesn't look like Billy and Silver are going to be chums anytime soon. It's almost like they set him up to be Ben Gunn, but, you know, he's not, because, like, this other guy is. It's an interesting and kind of sad ending for Billy. He was one of the few kind-hearted and loyal folks out there, you know, until he betrayed them all. I'll say this about old Billy Butterfingers, though. He sure can't hold on to boats. Nor can he drown, it seems. In Treasure Island, Billy is a messy drunk and dies, like, right away. Like, chapter one, right away. Aww. Rogers ends up in prison for his treason. You know, the whole Spanish thing. But in real life, he wrote another book or something and ended up the governor of Nassau again. Rogers gets his woody back. So yeah, the pirates don't win out in the long run. He does die on Nassau, but he's honored as the man who ended piracy in the Caribbean. So I guess he finally got his victory after all. Also, he died from illness, not a pirate thing or anything. Nothing remarkable. Long John and Maddie chill out for a bit, but just like Flint warned, the domestic life won't ever be enough, and the calling will come back to him. In the book, this is obvious, as 20 years later, Long John and the gang set out to find Captain Flint's treasure and reclaim it once and for all. A little nod to the books in the first season is that, just like in the show, in the books, Long John Silver pretends to be a cook to gain the trust of the crew and get work on the ship, which he plans to later commandeer. Cool! Now, my personal favourite ending. Captain Jack and Anne Bonny get another ship and crew and are allowed to continue pirating about. This is probably a nod to the privateering against the Spanish vessels, as remember that England and Spain are still at war while all this shit is going on. So historically, the Brits did commission pirates to raid Spanish vessels. They were called them privateers. They did this kind of off the book so as to help with the war effort in a way. It was nice to see Captain Jack's Jolly Roger. To this day, it's still the most infamous pirate flag that we all associate with pirates in all mediums. Sadly though, in reality, Jack's fate is is rather shitty. Not long after the events in Black Sails, maybe a couple of years, Jack and the gang end up in the crosshairs again, and sadly Jack Rackham and his crew are captured and Jack is hanged dead, probably pissing himself in doing so. I'm not being mean. Rackham is by far my favourite character in the show, I'm just saying that one usually pisses oneself when one is hanged. We get a little nod to Mary Read, which in the show she tries to pass herself off as a bloke, Mark Read. Her and Anne are real friends in history, and during their time in prison they claim to be preggers so they don't get hanged. Mary Read dies in prison, and the details are a bit foggy. Most agree it was due to complications during childbirth, but the circumstances are not 100% clear. Anne, however, gets out, and most speculate that she lives a long life, pushing 80 years. Some say she remarries, some say she goes to live with her old husband, some say she goes home to her father. No one knows for sure, but what we do know is that she wasn't killed during all of this shit. Her reported last words to Jack are pretty unflattering. "Had you fought like a man, you would not be hanged like a dog." Who knows how much of that final statement is true? Victors write the history, blah blah blah, but if it is true, that kind of takes the shine and the lovely ending and the romance between Jack and Anne out of Black Sails. So it's a bit, it kind of sucks, but you know, who knows. So Max becomes the neck that turns the head in Nassau. The head being, fuck yeah, Governor Featherstone, bitches! But like I mentioned, historically, Rogers comes back to town and fucks everything up for everyone. So, likely, if Max and Featherbottom were real characters, they would be disposed of or tossed aside a few years later. While we're on the subject, I wanted to talk about Teacher's death in the show. Blackbeard was killed during a battle with Rogers, but supposedly, not in the way they did in the show, he was said to have been shot multiple times and cut at least 20 times before finally succumbing to his wounds. I like this historical ending better, as it gives the mighty warrior a bit more glory. Hats off to Ray Stevenson too, I mean, what a fucking performance. I mean, in fact, you know what, hats off all around. Again, history turns to legend, legend to myth. We don't and we will never know the whole story about any of these characters, especially since most of them in Black Sails are fictional. But I do like how the show gave us a little victory for the pirates, a little happy ending, even though we know that shortly after, things are gonna get sad again. Anyway, I hope that wraps things up. If you have any more questions, I might be able to answer them. I'm not an expert at all. In fact, I fucking don't know anything, to be perfectly honest. No, I could have made all this up. What a great 4 years. And just in case you didn't know, the show wasn't cancelled. They chose to end it. They went out on their own terms and told the story they wanted to tell. Other shows could learn from this. Don't just fucking make shit for the sake of it. Write a fucking good story, tell it, and then fuck off and do something else. Good on your Black Sails for sticking to your guns. Also, how good is Bear McCreary? He wrote the theme song and he did the music for the show. What a hero. He is my all-time favourite score composer. Years ago, I did a really shitty cover of his Black Sails theme song, and Bear stumbled across it somehow and posted it to his Facebook. Made my fucking day. Hell, it made my whole month. I'll post the link to that terrible video in the description if you want to check it out. The end. P.S. Let's all take a moment to mourn the loss of Joji. You know, the samurai pirate who's been in the show since the very beginning. He has appeared in 35 out of the 38 episodes. That's even one more episode than Billy Bones, making him the 7th most reoccurring character in the show. It was sad to see that beautiful giant go down. I wish they gave him one line at the end at least. 4 years of silence, then suddenly he speaks. Oh man, I would have barred the fuck up. But alas, our silent warrior has returned to the eternal blue sky. R.I.P. Joji, you magnificent beast, you.